YOLO model was released, YOLO 12 to be specific. In this video, I'll be taking you through how to run inference using this YOLO 12 model and the Ultralytics library. So in order to make this script accessible to all of you, we'll be using Google Colab. So if you want to follow along, just make sure you open Google Colab and you follow every step I'll be taking in this video in order to arrive at the same point. Alright, so once you open Colab, make sure you click on runtime, change runtime type, and make sure T4 GPU is selected. Click on save, and this will automatically select the free GPU provided by Google Colab so that you can speed things up. Alright, so the next step is to bring in the images and the video files you want to run inference on. So I have some couple of them here, some images and two video files. So I'll just select all of them and make sure I drag them into Google Colab. So let me quickly do that. I'll drag this, and this will take some time to upload to Google Colab. Okay, so while this is uploading, just click on code, and we have to go ahead and install Ultralytics. So type pip install Ultralytics, and you can hit enter on this, and this will go ahead and install the Ultralytics package for us. Okay, so once Ultralytics is installed, what I'll go ahead and do is to clear this particular output or just hide it. And I'll go ahead and bring another code block and write from Ultralytics, we are going to import YOLO. So this is all we need to import from Ultralytics, and we can go ahead and run this one as well. The next step is to instantiate your model, and if you have been using Ultralytics, these are steps you are familiar with. So we'll just write model, write this in lowercase, and model is equal to, then we write YOLO, and in here we provide the model we want to use. So before we provide in this model, let's go back to the Ultralytics website and see the different variations of models YOLO V12 comes with. So these are different pre-trained models you can run. We have the Nano, which is the smallest, the small one, which is YOLO 12X. We also have YOLO 12M. These ones are quite big, and they are speed via tensor RT, T4 tensor RT is very slow. So if you want to run these bigger models, they are very accurate, but they require a lot of computational power. So we'll be going with the Nano one. So just make sure you type YOLO 12N inside this particular one. So I'll just go ahead and do that. And this is going to download this particular pre-trained model. So don't forget to add a PT to it. All right, so let me run this, and this will go ahead and download this particular pre-trained model from their GitHub repository. Okay, so we're done with that, and now the final thing is to start running inference on some of these images we have. So we'll save that in the results and just write your model, and inside here, you give it the path to the images you want to run the inference on. So first, let's grab this first one. Let's copy the path, and I'll just make sure I place it here. And another thing you need to specify here is save is equal to true, so that it will save this in your working directory. So once we run this, this is going to detect whatever is in the image and make sure it saves the result for us. So you can see result saved to runs, detect, and predict. And if you check here, you can see we have that folder runs. When you open runs, you get detect, and over here we have predict. So inside predict, we can see how well this particular image, we have the detections on them, so you can see everything is detected quite well, and you can even go ahead and download these images on your computer if you want to. So that's just by the way, but I can see pretty well that this model is performing great. Everything looks great. All right, so we can test it with the other images as well. So let's test it with the car. Copy the path and just replace this path here with this particular image. Alright, so I'll run this once again, and this will also be saving runs, detect, predict. So that should be, let's see, okay, you can see it right here. So let me double click on this, and here we go. So this is the image of a cyber truck, and you can see how well is detecting it. The confidence level is not actually that great, 0.54, but at least it has detected it well, and the bounding box looks great on this particular one. So I'll go ahead and download these images as well, because maybe I'll use them later. The final image I have here before we move on to the videos is soccer. So I'll also copy the path to soccer.jpg and I'll update it here. All right, so I'll run this one as well, and it should appear here. So let me just wait for it. Let's open it and see how well it will detect. And here we go, guys. So you can see, you can also expand this if you want to see it big. So it has detected almost everybody in this image, and the accuracy on the ball is about 92, which is looking great as well. So what I also do now is to download this particular image. Okay, so next we can move on to detecting objects in the video file as well, and it's also pretty much easy. All you need to do is to give the path to your video file right here. So I have dance 1.mp4, and I'm going to copy the path and test this one out. So I'll paste dance 1.mp4 here, run this, and this is going to look through all the frames and detect whatever is in there. So you can see about 96 frames. So it has detected everything, and the results are saved in run, detect, and predict. So let's wait for it here. And you can see we have dance 1.avi. So that's the format, it saves it automatically. So I'll go ahead and download this video as well. And I also have one last video, which is very big. So dance 2.mp4. And I can use that one as well and test it. But you guys should try that one out, because this video is big, and if I want to run it, it will take a whole lot of time. So this one is saved. So let's play this video and see how well objects has been detected using the YOLO12 model. So it's very, very, very short, but I think it's not bad. You can see how well it has detected the girls dancing, and it's looking great. And before I bring this tutorial to an end, I've actually run it on the longer video, so let me just find it out and play that video for you. Alright guys, so let me have your opinions in the comment section. Do you think this model is performing better than YOLO 11? Leave your thoughts in the comment section, and I would love to read them, and see you in the next tutorial.